A big hello and a warm welcome to all of you amazing and beautiful people out there. Welcome to my channel. In today's channeling session, I would be speaking about the public channelings I do and what happens when a person listens to the public channelings and they are not doing inner work. Without doing inner work, they listen to the public channelings. What happens after that? Now, some of the people that I'm going to mention over here are also a result of my personal experience with them. So there are two types of querents who come to me for reading. One, who are very eager to do inner work and they are immensely dedicated to their work. And two, are those people who listen to the channelings and go to multiple readers. Not just me, but multiple readers. And they keep trying from here and there to look for some kind of reason to blame their own inefficiencies and lack of making efforts. Please understand, in the twin flame journey, efforts are very much required, and this journey does not culminate in 1 day, 2 day, 1 month, 2 month, 3 month, 4 month, 5 month, 6 months. The only reason we do public channelings on a daily basis or on a regular basis is so the people who are genuinely doing inner work. Genuine inner work does not mean that you want all the time happy life. A genuine twin flamer understands that every day is different. There can be good days, there can be bad days, there will be challenges and there will be rewards. There are some people who are looking only for positive answers. A good reader, I don't know about good or bad reader, but I can say that an honest reader is not there to please everyone. Because if I please you and give you wrong answers, which are not positive, if you want to know when will your twin come back, or if you want to know if the 3D union is going to happen also or not, or if any other question you have, any other doubt you have, and the answer comes out to be a no for you or a negative answer for you, or the answer says that you need to make effort, you need to work hard on yourself, you need to heal your wounds, or you need to release your negative energy. If everyone was perfect on this planet, then what was the need of twin flame work? So some of the people are looking only for positive answers. But positive answers or negative answers is not the criteria for a reading or for therapy. Because in the therapy also we find out there are many issues that a person has in them by their own self. This twin flame journey is different from a karmic journey or a three-dimensional journey. For the karmic world, for the other people, they are only here to pay off their previous life's karmas and their debts. And this is the reason why they have karmic marriages. They don't even reach to the point where they can have a twin flame or even know about twin flame. If by chance you have landed on this information, then please make the most out of it. All those people who are involved in karmic activities, they are living in a bhokta bhav, which means they are not here as observers. They are here as reactors. They will constantly react. They will constantly react to good and they'll constantly react to bad things. As an observer, you don't make so many reactions. Okay? And for most of the people, the twin flame journey actually starts figuring out in their late 20s. If you are really young and still you understand twin flame journey, or you have some knowledge for it, or you have some liking towards it, then also you must start doing your source integration ASAP. By the time people reach in their late 20s, that is the time they are going through a rebirth phase. By the time they are 29, 27, 27 is actually the mark, 27, 28. For the twin flame, life is not as other people. For other people, by the time they are 27, 28, their life is almost over. They are going to have children and they are going to just move on then. For other people, you get born and then you go to school, you go to college, then you look for a job and then you look for a partner, or you fall in love, you get married, whether it's arranged or whether it's love marriage. And by 27, you have babies, and then next thing is you look after the babies and the babies will go to school, college, same cycle will repeat. For an ascensioner, their awakening starts at late 20s. And by the time they are 35, that life's karma is completed. And this is the reason why some people, they feel a huge change after the age of 35. They actually feel that a new life has been given to them and their previous limbo life is over. But if you continue to live in a non-equanimous state, then you will keep creating more and more karma. And that is why some of the twin flamers also go through instant karma, which means they create any negative energy within themselves and instantly something will happen to them. So please understand, this twin flame journey, don't make it a 3D journey. Because if you are going to make it a 3D journey, what's the point? And I know the genuine twin flamers are getting it, the star seeds are getting it, the light workers are getting it, the people who have a natural inclination towards animals, children and flora and fauna, they will get it. But if you are getting triggered, then don't blame the world. Don't blame the world. We as a medium, anybody as a medium, our job is to give out the correct information, the right information. Information is not meant to please you. As I said, there are some people who speak about how great sexual merge is between twin flames, which is absolute utter garbage knowledge. Because twin flames are normally asexual, they don't even care about such things. They are looking for true love and those poor souls have gotten so much harmed and troubled only because they had to live a fake life of 3D world. And they have done many things, even sexual abuse or other type of abuse they had to go through. They took it only because they were told that this is how the world works. This is how all relationships work. So if the boyfriend or the husband or anybody, any other partner was demanding certain things from them, they had no option but to take it. It's only when they start awakening, they realize that I don't need to take it all. I don't have to. I can choose to live in an ascension lifestyle. But what is the reason why you do inner work? Is the reason only to get married to your twin flame? Or is the reason only to get all your materialistic desires fulfilled? If that is your reason, then I don't think people have understood twin flame journey. People who are on the twin flame journey, first of all, it is predestined for them to be on the path. Since this information is everywhere, not only there are people who misunderstand this journey, but also there are some sections of people who are giving out false information about twin flames because they don't understand twin flame journey themselves. Okay? Twin flame love is not sexual love. Please understand, twin flame love is not sexual love. It is asexual and unconditional love. If you have sexual love for your divine masculine, you are not experiencing love, but you are experiencing lust. Second thing is, twin flame love is not about wish fulfillment all the time. When will I meet my twin flame in 3D? When will he take me out for a date? When will he have sex with me? When will he kiss me? When will he marry me? When will he do this? When will he do that? Some people are asking these questions after 11 years, 12 years, 5 years, 10 years. But they don't understand that again and again, repeatedly I say that what happens in 5D, that will be shown in 3D. If you have a 5D union with your DM, you will have something going on in 3D as well. And most important thing is to be in peace. If you don't have peace of mind, you can have the wealth of the whole world on your feet, but you will not be happy. And let me tell you, if you have been going to 10, 5, 6 multiple readers and you are not happy with their reading, you don't feel satisfied, then please don't waste your money and time on one more reader, which is me. Don't come to me because my readings are not typical readings like how other people do. Neither am I doing typical public channelings. I want to show the truth to all those people who want to see the truth. If you cannot handle the truth, then this is not for you. And secondly, I want to motivate the genuine twin flamers. Because in all of this confusion and all of this hodgepodge and all of this haphazardness, the poor, the nice people, the actually good people, they also suffer. My channel is specially designed for those people who understand devotion, discipline, and who believe in equanimity of the mind. How do you become equanimous? If you are going to dance like a peacock when you are happy and start crying and blaming God for all your problems during bad situations, then I'm sorry to say you have not learnt even 1% of equanimity. Equanimity teaches you to be the same in all situations. In happy situations or sad situations. In both the situations, you get an opportunity to check your own inner mental balance. Alright? And when people come to me for therapy and they improve and they feel better, after some time, they start feeling independent, they are happier, and they see a lot of change in their 3D. It's not because, you know, some magic has been done. It's because they are working hard. It's because they respect the teacher and they respect universe and they respect source and they respect their master. And they put in their effort every single day. Because inner work happens every single day. There are some people who do their assignments on a daily basis without skipping anything. There are people who understand, they have patience. I have seen some people who mail me for a reading and they want the reading right away. In 5 minutes, in 10 minutes, there is no patience whatsoever. And then some people talk about being under effect of dark magic, black magic, or dark forces. Let me tell you, what do dark forces do? One of the biggest things dark forces do is they bring in confusion in the mind of a person, and that throws them from their base and foundation. Even if a person is going in the right direction, even if they have all type of help, the dark energies make them feel that everything is wrong, nothing is correct, they will be confused. And after the confusion, they will start thinking that they are not on the correct path. This is what dark energies do. But if you are going to constantly blame the dark energies, you are also going to end up giving them more power. And in my channelings, when I speak about black magic or dark energies or the reptilian energies, I'm not telling you so that you start blaming everything on them. I'm telling you so that you get out of the blame game. You stop blaming anybody, not even your parents you have to blame. But you need to know the truth. You need to know that certain elements come into your DNA via birth, via programming, and via societal flaws. And you rise above them when you don't blame them. When you say that these are also victims of other victims. If your mother has narcissism, which has a huge impact on the twin flame journey, by the way. If your mother did not take care of you, did not love you enough, did not stand by you, criticized you way too much, it means that she also must have gone through the same thing. She also had to always be, try to be good enough, but she was never good enough in the eyes of her mother. And same thing happened for her mother. It's a generational curse. Please understand, in the twin flame journey, we speak about ancestral curses and generational curses. I have also shared one information video on ancestral curses, how to release ancestral curses. Because so many of us have these imprints and implants which have been passed over from one generation to another, one ancestor to another, finally it has reached us, and we are supposed to put an end to it. We are the ones who have to draw a line, we are the ones who have to stop. And that's exactly how you heal your template. You don't let it go any further. You don't let it go any further. It's like there is a fire in the forest. Okay, there is a fire in the forest, and wherever there is a creek or a river in between, the forest will stop. The fire in the forest will stop. So you are that river and you are that creek, because once the fire touches you, it cannot go any further. So whatever damage has happened before you, it has already happened, you cannot help it. But after you, there will be no damage. And then with your energy, because you are the Shakti, the masculine will get the energy too. Now in some cases, this also happens that a lot of runners, a lot of divine masculines, because they've been listening to this information at so many places, they start assuming that they are divine feminines. Because, you know, some of the qualities of the divine feminines are very beautiful. How they nurture, how kind-hearted they are, how loving they are. divine masculine also has some qualities. The runners also have some qualities. But this type of spiritual inner work, we try to help mostly the divine feminines because their root chakra is blocked. And because of which they don't have any financial help, or they are in difficult situations sometimes. And they are not in difficult situations because they are lazy or they don't want to do hard work. They are obviously doing hard work, but it's just that because of lack of support and the narcissistic abuse, they are taking time to grow. But once they grow, there is no stopping them. There is no turning around for them. There is no looking back for them. If you have any type of sexual experience with your twin flame, divine masculine or divine feminine, that much is more than enough. I have said it in previous channelings also, and it also sometimes triggers the runner phase. Okay, why? Because both of them are not that type of person. And those people who say, oh, it is great, it is wonderful, then it is definitely either with a karmic or with a false twin. With a karmic or false twin, that particular experience would be very pleasurable, and that's the reason why it is addictive. But the DM and the DF, they would always have a strange kind of a experience. Like, it will not even look like how normally what people do. They are not into kinky stuff, they are not into macho sadism, or they are not into, you know, all the crazy things that you listen about. They are not into that as well. In fact, they just want to spend time with each other. They would be very happy if they get to watch a movie together, or go for a meal together, go for a walk together, talk about anything, sit under the stars, you know, listen to music together. They can hug each other for hours. They can just hang out with each other. They can cook, clean, do whatever they want. Because their energy is different than other people. They don't have three-dimensional energy. They are already born with 5D energy. It's not so difficult to understand, but it will be difficult to understand if you are stuck in karmic entanglements. So my friends, if you are looking for a reading or a therapy session, a personal session, a one-on-one session, if you are looking for any of this, then please come with a responsible attitude. Think that I also have to put in my effort, and I have to be patient, and I have to be understanding, and I have to be equanimous. The readers are not sitting with a magic wand. The therapist or the practitioners, the spiritualist, the coaches, all these people, they are there to help you. They are there to show you the path. But who has to walk on the path? I can show you 100 paths, or other people can show you 100 paths. But will you walk on it, or you will just keep looking at it and saying, yeah, it's a nice path or it's a bad path? You need to walk on it. Then only the path will work for you, then only the journey will work for you. Without doing any efforts and continuing to be negative and continuing to blame, continuing to get frustrated will not help. Complaining never helps. If you know there is a problem, repeating this problem, that I have this problem, I have this problem, I have this problem, will not change the problem. On the contrary, it will intensify it. You have to think, I have a problem, what is the solution? Okay? Because if 5 coaches can't satisfy you, 10 coaches can't satisfy you, another one cannot. It's as simple as that. Alright? So I wish all of those people, like, I'm very happy also in this channeling session. I do want to thank all of those amazing people who are doing inner work, and I keep thanking them because they are the ones who are contributing to this planet. Because of their responsible nature, because of their kind-heartedness, because of their, nurturing energies, because of their abilities to move on from bad things, to move on from the past. They are doing a wonderful job. And anyone on this planet, we cannot satisfy everyone. We cannot please everyone. There will always be somebody or the other who will complain, who will be upset. Okay? But even if one person picks it up, if one person, one genuine person also figures it out, that's when you feel satisfied and you feel grateful to the universe, to source. Because we are just a medium. We are just in the middle. We are just a vessel. We cannot take credit. If you have a problem with anything in life, it's because you're taking too much control. As a person, we need to let go and we need to let God. Alright? So, to all of those amazing people who are doing brilliant work, putting in efforts daily, and they are being patient. They know this journey does not happen in one day or 2 days. Even those who practice law of attraction, to some extent, they are also working on surrendering. Without surrendering, their desires cannot be manifested. Their intentions will not turn into manifestations. Right? And who do you surrender to? Do you surrender to the devil or do you surrender to God? Obviously, we surrender to God. Because if people by mistake surrender to ego, initially everything would look very nice, but ego always betrays. Because ego is run by the devil and devil has this nature of betraying people. Anybody who will trust the devil will take away their soul. Even though initially it will show you all the great things, all the amazing things, but later on, the truth will be revealed to you. Okay? So, even at any given time, you realize anything, you're stuck, you're trapped, you're sad, you're feeling dark, you're feeling negative, make a prayer to God. Instead of blaming and complaining, instead of finding faults in the whole world, just make a prayer to God and God will give you the bestest solution and God will give you confidence. And that's all for now, for this one. I will see you soon in another one. One love and peace out.